Now, the US House Speaker John Boehner has just been speaking. He signalled that he's keen to get started on fiscal cliff talks with President Obama. And his re-election shows that people also want something for nothing. That's according to our next guest, who claims the US is just steps away from financial ruin and the real fiscal cliff is a dollar crisis. Peter Schiff is CEO of Euro-Pacific Capital and author of The Little Book of Bull Moves in Bear Markets. Peter, thanks for us. Look, the dollar's always just a short step away from a massive crisis, but then so is the yen, so is the euro, so is the pound.
Well, that's the problem with fiat currencies when you have no intrinsic value. But I would say that we are much closer to a cliff than the other countries that you mentioned, because our economy is inherently more unstable. We depend on the charity of the rest of the world. We have enormous current account and trade deficits that have to be funded. The world has to keep lending us money, despite the fact that there's no possibility that we can ever pay it back with legitimate money. We either have to default or we have to inflate. And I think the real fiscal cliff is going to come when we run out of credit and we do face that crisis.
Peter, you've got growth. You've got an awful lot more growth than we've got over here.
We don't have real growth. All we do is spend borrowed money. That's not growth. We can goose the GDP with stimulus, but at what cost? How much money do we have to borrow in order to get that phony growth? You know, if you look at this fiscal cliff, the supposed fiscal cliff that's coming up, how did we get it? That was the can that we kicked down the road a year ago. We made a deal to raise the debt ceiling by postponing the pain of spending cuts and tax increases, and now they want to kick the can down the road again and still pretend that they're doing something about our fiscal imbalances. The real fiscal cliff is if we cancel these so-called spending cuts and tax hikes and don't go over this little, you know, this little molehill, but we fall over the mountain that's coming.
If we assume that we go down a path where we print even more and then we start to inflate, what do you think is the highest level of inflation on exit from these events that Bernanke would feel was nonetheless a success?
Well, they're going to lie about inflation. Inflation is already much higher than any reasonable central bank would tolerate. In fact, if you look at recent political polls that were conducted in the United States, the single most important issue that worries the average American right now is inflation. Inflation is already a bigger concern for average Americans than unemployment or the housing market, yet the government deliberately creates more inflation because it thinks that's the solution to our problems. It's not. It simply makes those problems worse. But we can try to hide the extent of the inflation through these doctored up CPI numbers or other government measures that claim to show inflation. They hide inflation. But at some point, it's going to be so bad that there's no way the government's going to be able to pretend it doesn't exist. Who knows how high those numbers are going to be, but they're certainly going to be double digit. And I don't think the first digit's going to be a one.
Double digit, Peter. Is that more than one? Okay. 20, more than 20%.
Well, more than 10. I'm saying we're going to have double digit inflation in the United States, but the first digit may not be a one. It may be a two. It may be a three. And I hope that we avoid hyperinflation, you know, Zimbabwe style, Weimar Republic style, but we're going to have to make some dramatic changes. We're going to have to go over a much bigger fiscal cliff than the one everyone's talking about now if we want to avoid hyperinflation.
Peter, where are the savers of the world? If they're going to buy treasuries, where are they going to put their money?
Well, they buy gold. Buy silver. Buy something that a central banker can't create out of thin air. And if you want to buy stocks, look at some of the emerging markets, look at some of the resource-based economies that still have sounder fundamentals, where the governments aren't as reckless. Maybe they have surpluses, they have trade surpluses, they have higher savings rates, they don't have as much regulation, they don't have as big a social welfare state, they don't have people looking for something for nothing, collecting Social Security, Medicare, welfare programs like that. Look for countries that have more freedom and less government, and that's where you can invest. But own real things. You know, get dividends on stocks. Don't clip coupons on bonds, because the biggest losers are going to be the savers, unfortunately. And we need savings. That's where economic growth comes from, under consumption and saving, yet we have central banks punishing people for doing exactly what we need them to do.
Peter, always good to talk to you. We've got to let you go, unfortunately. We could discuss an awful lot more, but for now, thank you. Peter Schiff from Euro Pacific Capital.